The coronavirus is spreading all over the world, and teachers, students are separated from each other. They all are at their homes. Nobody is allowed to come to college or schools. Teachers are asking how they can conduct online classes in such a situation when everybody, all students are at separate places and teacher is at separate place. So I suggested a way, go YouTube live and ask students to connect. But there were some limitations. Teacher is able to broadcast himself, but he is unable to hear others or see others. So they asked, is there any way so they feel like they are taking a live class where they can see students and they can hear their students? I said, yes, there is a way. And the way is to use Zoom communication tool or software or app, whatever you call it. So in this video, what I'm going to do, I'm going to tell you how to take online classes using this application, which is known as Zoom communication. I believe after watching this video, you will be able to use Zoom to take online classes. So why wait? Let's start. So you can download Zoom from zoom.us website, or which I prefer, it's 99.com. If you go to 99.com, you will find Zoom here as well. Simply select it and go down, click on get your 99. It will download an exe file. Simply double click on it and it will install Zoom on your laptop. Once Zoom is installed on your PC, then you need to log in order to host a meeting. So you need to sign up. Simply click on sign up, fill the form, and then you will be able to log in to the Zoom application. After Zoom is installed, when you will open it, you will log in. So you can see your account here, and then you want to create a new class, which is known as new meeting. So click on this new meeting icon. So once it is connected, it will ask you an option to join with computer audio or not. So you can simply click on this join with computer audio. When you see this screen where this Zoom ID is present and you can see this end meeting option, this means you are now hosting a class or hosting a meeting. So the next thing is to invite your students or invite other people into this meeting. So you click on this invite link. When you click on this invite link, you will see the meeting ID and the password to join the meeting. You will share this with your students or with the people who want to attend this meeting. You can simply also copy this URL. I'll paste it here so you can see how this URL looks. Paste this URL and share with the people, or you can send them via email also. So once we have this Zoom ID and password, so how will a user log in? That I'll show you. So now what I am doing, I am logging to another PC from where we will attend this meeting. The person who want to join this meeting, all he has to do is enter the meeting ID. So the meeting ID is shared by you, and he will type his name. So you can see the other person do not need to create an account on Zoom in order to join a meeting. Only if you are hosting a Zoom meeting, then you need to create an account. So after this, any name can be entered here, and I'll click on join. Then it will ask meeting password, and you have already shared this meeting password with the person. I'll type this password here and click on join meeting. The person will be asked to join with video or join without video. So I'll click on join without video in the beginning. We can always switch on the video anytime during the meeting. Once it is done, you can see the other person's video here. See, I am logged in as ET Mantra e-learning solution. The other person is being logged in from Yogendra. You can understand this from this front facing camera and from this side facing camera. So right now, this is not connected. So I have to select on client PC, join with computer audio. Now It is connected with the audio. And what I'll do, client can always mute themselves, or you can also mute them. Simply click this and make it full screen. After that, you can click on this speaker view, or you can switch to gallery view. It's up to you. You can always see how many participants are there by clicking on this manage participant link. You can see these are the participants, and you can also see which participant is mute and video is off. So I'll now switch on the video from this PC. So you can see these two videos now. What I am going to do now, I am going to log in from one more machine. Okay, and this time I am going to log in by a mobile phone. This is Android phone. So in Android phone, you need Zoom app. Once Zoom app is installed, you will enter the meeting ID. So again, we need to open this invite tab to see the meeting ID. I'll type the meeting ID here. And click on join meeting. Meeting password is being asked. So I'll type the password also. Once you type the password, click on OK. It will ask to switch on the camera. I'll allow. So you can see the option join with video or join without video. So I click on join with video. Once this person is also joined, third person is now joined. You can see his video also here, if he has allowed it. So now I am connected with three different devices, but this one is host and these two are clients. Okay. And you can also see the name of the device, or in fact that name which will be typed by the person in the settings on Zoom application, the name will come here. So at any time the person can stop their video. See, right now I have stopped the video from here, and we can also stop video from other device. So anybody can stop their video, or you can keep talking. Then what you can do, you can share screen also. So when you will click on share screen, you will see all the windows available to you for sharing. So what I'll do, I'll share some screen. The software I want to teach, I'll share that. So I'll select that and click on share. Other people will be able to now see this. Okay. They are now seeing it. I am taking a snapshot from mobile so that I'll be able to share it with you. And you are already seeing how it is looking in client's PC. Now, what you can see now, we are broadcasting the screen. And I can always check if other people are sharing their video with me. Other people can always share their video with audio. So audio is also coming to me and video is also being shared. So as you can see, multiple people can join at a time. Okay. So I'll stop the video from one PC at least so that I can save some bandwidth. Now what else can be done apart from sharing this thing? Now you have to work on this particular software. Whatever work you will do, other people will be able to see it. Other people are able to see what you are doing on this software. So this way you can teach software, you can teach programming languages, you can teach other things with the help of this. Similarly, you can also present your slides in this Zoom meeting. Correct. The next thing is a very good feature. When you go up, you can see this new share option, or you can see this annotate option also. Click on this annotate, then you will see these tools available to you, and you can actually annotate anywhere on the screen. See, over the software also I can annotate, which is a very good feature. If you are taking classes and you want to write onto that particular software to make it more clear to students, then you will be able to do it, and your client will be always looking to this. They will see the same screen, means all annotations with the software are visible to them. So I again take a snapshot from my mobile so that I can share it with you. Then when you are done, you can clear all the drawings. or you can clear only your drawings. This means others can also annotate, but it's a little advanced level. So I'll first clear all drawings from here. Then I'll hide this tool also. The next thing you can do is sharing the whiteboard itself. So you share a whiteboard, share it. So other people will be able to see this whiteboard itself. And with the help of these tools, you can draw over it. So this particular laptop where I am hosting does not support very good writing, but the other laptop that I am using to attend this meeting supports very good writing method. Using this pen, I can write there. So I'll do this. For that, what I have to do, I have to allow everybody to participate. So like in the whiteboard, there must be some option for anybody to share. So yeah, see, this disable participants annotation is already off. Okay, so this means other can draw on it. So I am going to draw with this pen on client's screen, not on the host screen, correct? So I'll do that. See, as you can see, I am writing with this digital pen. The same way you can also write. So if you have this pen and a laptop that supports this pen, then you will be able to write. And on the mobile, there is nothing to worry about because on mobile, it's already supports. Correct? So I can simply draw. There must be an option to scribble. Yes, there is an option. See, now I am drawing on mobile and you can see it's visible here. Correct? I can also use highlighter. There are many options actually. So I'll now clear from mobile and now I can clear everything from here itself. Clear all drawings. This way you can actually present whiteboard, you can present your screen, you can present your screen and annotate that particular screen. You can always see how many participants are there. You can also close this, like this pause share or stop share. So you will get back to this speaker view. You can change this view to gallery view also. And when other people want to ask a question to you, they can actually raise their hand, which is available in the device itself. So I'll try to do that from other device, other client. See, from here, I can click on raise hand and that hand should be visible somewhere here on this screen. See, you can see the hand is visible. So I can give this person opportunity to talk. So I can unmute him from here and now he will be able to ask questions from me to me. And I can, if I want, I can decline his request. I can click on lower hand. So the hand is now gone. So this is what you can do with the help of Zoom meetings. Zoom meeting is already being used in multiple universities. So it's very convenient to use it here also. You can use this to take online classes where everybody can talk to everybody. And you are always, means as a host, you are always in control. Although it has some limitations over other softwares, for example, YouTube Live. So both are different and I am going to record a video on both, comparing both of these options so that you can select the correct one for you. The limitations with Zoom meetings is that it supports maximum 100 participants with free option, with free subscription. And you can host a meeting only for maximum 40 minutes. You can't host a meeting for more than 40 minutes. So I hope now you will be able to use Zoom for your classes. Try to use it. If you face any problem, I am always here to help you. I will be happy to hear your questions and I will definitely answer all of your questions. Thank you. So this is how you use Zoom to conduct online classes. Although it also has some limitations. For example, you can't add more than 100 students for free subscription of Zoom communication software. And you can't conduct a class for more than 40 minutes for group meetings. These limitations are not there in YouTube Live. This is why I also recommend YouTube Live. But both of the software, YouTube Live as well as Zoom, has their pros and cons. And I have created a video to compare both of these things which can be used to conduct online classes. I am going to publish that video very soon. Just subscribe my YouTube channel ET Mantra and you will get notification when I'll publish that video. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please share it with other teachers also so they can also conduct online classes for their students. Thank you very much.